Hi guys! In this video, I'm going to discuss on laws of radicals. Okay, first law, n root of a raised to the power of n is equal to n root of a to the power of n equals a. So, example number one, cube root of 6 cubed. So, applying this one, this will just be equal to 6. Then, number two, fifth root of x to the power of 5, so we have the same index and power here, so we're going to have the answer as x. And second one, nth root of a times b is just equal to nth root of a times nth root of b. So in here, what we're going to do is we're going to find the factors of the radicand. For example, here, this is square root of 50, so we're going to find the factors of 50 in which one of the factors is a perfect square. So square root of 50, number 1. So we're going to find the factors of this number that is one of the factors is a perfect square, so that would be 25 times 2. So 50 is 25 times 2, so you can have that one as square root of 25 times 2. Then applying this one here, this will be equal to square root of 25 times square root of 2. And since 25 is a perfect square, so we can express 25 as square root of 5 squared, then applying law number 1. So we're going to have here square root of 5 squared is 5, so your answer will be 5 times the square root of 2. Then number 2, cube root of 24. So in here, this is index 3 or order 3. So we are going to find the factors of 24 wherein one of the factors is a perfect cube. So 24, the factors of 24 are, we can have the factors as cube root of 8 times 3 because 8 is a perfect cube. And we can express this one as cube root of 8 times the cube root of 3. So cube root of 8 is, you can express that one as cube root of 2 cubed. So in here, this is equal to 2. This is cube root of 2 cubed times the cube root of 3. So this is equal to 2, so we're going to have the answer as 2 times the cube root of 3. The next law will be nth root of a divided by b will be equivalent to nth root of a divided by nth root of b, where b is greater than 0. So square root of 75 divided by square root of 3, you can just apply this one. So that will be equal to square root of 75 divided by 3, and 75 divided by 3 is equal to 25. So we're going to have here square root of 25. Then square root of 25, that will be square root of 5 squared, and this will be equal to 5. Then number 2, cube root of negative 27 over a to the power of 6. So you can have this one as cube root of negative 27 over cube root of a to the power of 6. Then you can express cube root of negative 27 as cube root of negative 3 cubed. Then a to the power of 6, that will be cube root of a squared cubed. And this will be equal to cube root of negative 3 cubed is negative 3. Then cube root of a squared cubed, that will be a squared. So you just apply here the first law. So your answer for number 2 will be negative 3 over a squared. Then letter D, mth root of nth root of a, that will be equal to m times the nth root of a, that will be equal to nth root of mth root of a. So in here, you can just interchange the order or index. So we can interchange m by n and n by m. So example number 1 here, let's have 6th root of 9. 9 here, since 9 is a perfect square, so you can just express 6 as 3 and 2. So this is a perfect square, so you can just express that one as cube root of the square root of 9. And square root of 9, that will be cube root of square root of 3 squared. Square root of 3 squared is 3, so your answer here will be cube root of 3. Number 2, cube root of square root of 8. 9 here, since 8 is a perfect cube, so we can just interchange here index 2 and index 3. So we're going to have index 2 outside and index 3 inside. So we can just have that one as square root of the cube root of 8. Then cube root of 8, we can express that one as cube root of 2 cubed. Then cube root of 2 cubed is just equal to 2, so your answer will be square root of 2. I hope this video helped you. If you have questions, please comment down below and see you next time.